NSFW, prison guards of Reddit, what's the most disturbing thing you've dealt with? I worked in juvenile corrections. One of my kids threw a tantrum before lights out. After lots of questioning, we eventually learned that it was because one of the other kids was threatening to abuse him. From when my dad was a guard, two prisoners trying to kill a third prisoner. The shank broke, so they put a pen in his ear and stomped on it. It came out his mouth and he lived. I had a neighbor who was a CO at a juvenile prison in my city. There was a new kid at the prison one day. He was apparently very shy and very quiet. He had the misfortune of sharing a cell with one of the more violent inmates. His second nightmare, his cellmate unscrewed a screw from a bench and sat on his bed in the middle of the night, and he woke up. He said, "I'ma make you a pirate," and shoved the screw into the new kid's eye. My neighbor was the first CO to respond to the kid's calls for help. When asked why he shoved a screw in the new kid's eye, he claimed that he looked at him the wrong way. That's a pretty ducked up situation if you ask me, and not one I'd like to deal with under any circumstances. I knew a prison guard at Winston Green in Birmingham, and he said the most disturbing thing about Fred West was how jovial he was. The officers kept forgetting and laughing at his jokes and stuff and then thinking, this goo sexually tortured his own daughter and buried her in concrete. Not me, but my cousin. One day she found a guy cutting his D open and sticking tiny plastic balls inside the wounds, and the inmates wanted it to heal like that so when he gets out it would pleasure the ladies. Edit, not fixing my smaller typo. My dad used to work as a CO and he would never tell me any stories about his time there until one day of constant badgering he told me the tale of the Easter surprise. Easter morning, one of the inmates thought it would be a brilliant idea to get completely naked and shove a toilet scrubber all the way up his ass so the only part visible was his bristled bunny tail. He then proceeded to scream that he was the Easter bunny while trying to hop around and avoid the oncoming guards. Edit, thanks for the gold, kind stranger. Not really disturbing in a traditional sense, but still made me uncomfortable. I'm a CO at the Denver complex for the Department of Corrections. Seeing James Holmes, the Aurora Theater shooter, come through our processing after getting sentenced. I'd seen this man's face and heard the stories for 2 years on TV, but seeing him in person just slapped me in the face with a weird sense of reality. I don't really know what I expected, but it was pretty disturbing to me personally. If that doesn't count, then seeing an offender hanging from a sheet in their cell. Duck this thread. Too many dice getting chopped off and there's even a ducking pirate. I was a co at a max unit for several years. I'll just make a list. I had a guy slice his own neck in front of me. Had a guy hang himself on a night we were very short. I had to stand there and wait several minutes for another person before entering the cell. We were able to save him. Had a guy hang himself and succeed. Had a guy collapse in front of me and die. He had a brain aneurysm. Had a guy try to connect his tattoo gun to the light. He electrocuted himself. He died. I've caught people having sex twice. Once was willingly and the other was for protection. I've been on the third row and the power went out. It was pitch black for about 20 seconds. Power loss was always the scariest thing to me. Had a guy who had come in with a relatively minor sentence, now serving over 100 years consecutively due to crimes he committed while incarcerated. He would attack any co he had a chance to. He was notorious for popping his door open and attacking cos. Had different guys try to attack the nurses on a few occasions. If you ever go to prison, don't sue this. They're the ones who decide if you need to go to a hospital or go back to your cell and drink water. Had to fight a psych patient in the back of an ambulance on a transport. Had to sit through multiple surgeries because someone has to have eyes on the inmate at all times. Once I had to wrestle with an inmate when he was coming out of his anesthesia. He was out of it and freaked out. I have tons more, but I'm on mobile and it's a pain to type this much. I work closely with all the prisons in the state. There's one notorious inmate who likes to jerk off and throw his semen in everyone's face. Fellow inmates, guards, it doesn't matter. He's not strict to semen. Sometimes piss and it. Just whatever he can get his hands on. One of my old roommates worked in the county jail. He came home one day with a stone face, so I asked him how work was. All he said was, "I saw a guy eat his shampoo because he couldn't shower, then uncontrollably puke and it himself. That's how my day went." Jail. Not for me. I have to. One CO friend at a city lockup knew an inmate who everyone called the gingerbread man. He would get naked and cover himself head to toe in poop. He was trying to get insanity, but his crimes were drug dealing related. He was beaten rather badly a number of times by the 3 or 5 guys he shared a cell with. He stopped eventually, then went to real prison. Another CO I know knew a guy who was kept solo because he kept trying to give people his HIV, filling plastic pen tubes with blood. He would try to stab people, and then blow into the tube. He died one night when my CO friend wasn't there, when he broke a light in the infirmary instead slashing himself up and threatening to give anyone who came in HIV. They locked the door and told him to wash up under the shower. He wouldn't. And he bled out hours later. Some COs get reprimands and demerits or whatever. But nobody lost a job because the investigator could understand not wanting to be given HIV from a bleeding psycho armed with long shards of broken glass. Edit. I just asked. And the guy with HIV didn't die. He passed out from blood loss and was revived. Former prison guard. I had to escort a new prisoner to medical. I had no idea why until we got to medical. He had bandages all over both legs and he walked stiff-legged, couldn't bend his legs. When he sat down, the nurse started removing bandages to expose rotted, abscessed flesh. He was a heroin addict and was injecting in his legs. His legs were so swollen and gangrenous that the smell almost put me down. When he tried to bend his right leg, the skin split and infection oozed all over the floor. The doctor looked at me and immediately called for another guard to come to the room. I asked what was wrong and she said, "You're going into shock. I need you to leave before you pass out." Surprised at what she said, I protested. But she demanded that I leave. My way out. I started to feel lightheaded. I looked in a mirror and noticed that I was sheet white, normally a brown guy. I've seen people hanging. I've seen people stabbed and shot. I saw a guy blow his head off with a shotgun. When I was in the Corps, I've pulled burned bodies out of a crashed CH-53E. This, by far, was the worst thing I've ever seen. My friend's mom was a prison guard when I was younger. We went there our whole class. And she told us about how inmates would break down mentally. One story I remember her telling multiple times. She was on night shift, and was suddenly alerted by screams of help. The screams came from a cell, and her being careful, she looked inside the door window. There, in the farthest corner, an inmate was on a chair, screaming, pleading for help, and trying to avoid something on the ground. "Mom, what's wrong, inmate?" "Inmate, it's the chickens. Please get them out." While still standing on the chair, jumping and crying, "Mom, what chickens? Where are they?" "Inmate, everywhere. Please get them out." So friend's mom opened the cell door and guided the invisible chickens out. The inmate calmed down. But as friend's mom closed the cell door, he screamed, "You forgot one." So she went back in and got the remaining chicken. Note, the inmate in this story was a big ass biker dude. He was probably on drugs. But I think it's a fun story. A buddy of mine is a guard at a women's prison. He once has to confiscate a Jolly Rancher dildo. These crafty women collected Jolly Ranchers and molded a rainbow-colored shaft, then wrapped it in saran wrap from the kitchen and passed it around. Not a prison officer, but my dad spent 26 years working as one in the UK. Brixton, then Belmarsh. Heard a lot of crazy stories, including how the IRA prisoners used to be. Mess strikes used to happen frequently. They used to cover themselves in their own feces, wait for the guards to go into the cell and attack them. They then just started hosing them down through the service flap. He also told me swallowing razor blades was fairly common amongst prisoners. Although one time this guy didn't think that would be enough, so he slotted a bunch of razor blades amongst the bristles of a toilet brush and then rammed the whole thing down his throat up to the handle. He lived. Inmates in a level 5 yard bunk up 2 to a cell. One inmate decided to pledge himself to his cellie for life by allowing him to cut his testicles out with a reproposed safety razor blade. Much blood. 010 would not recommend. Not me, but a friend who worked in a state prison down south for a few years. On his first day of the job, a very tall, very intimidating inmate stood over him and said, "I could kill you right now if I wanted to. Glad I don't work in a prison. I'd poop my pants." Not me but my dad. He works at a state pen. Worked death row. Never really fazed him. Then he met this guy, dude is on a 24 watch. Never seen my dad as disturbed after watching this post for 8 hours. Honey buns are routinely spent on sex as a currency. Also, the amount of ramen noodles a normal college student eats in a week would make you rich as duck on the block. I'm a care of at a max prison. I've seen an inmate lick his own it off his walls. I've seen an inmate cut up where his cell floor was covered in blood. They will dilute it in water to make it look like there is more blood than there is. The inmate lived, and I've seen an inmate hog tie his cellie and put a plastic bag on his head and then put his property box on top of his head. Inmate survived. Guys I've worked with have seen worse. Like an inmate ripping open his guts. An inmate pulling chicken bones out of his urethra. And of course inmates who have successfully hung themselves or got beat to death by their cellie. When I used to work in the jail, I initially thought people covering themselves in their cells in feces was as bad as it ever got. Then one of the inmates in my partner's cell block had a miscarriage into the toilet and smeared the afterbirth all over the cell door. Suddenly, a Picasso doesn't seem all that bad. I don't work corrections, but I still respond to local jails to complete assessments for inmates on suicide watch. Arrived just in time for sheriffs to locate a dead inmate with one eyeball popped out of his head. After watching security footage, they discovered another inmate was choking him while they were ducking and the guy killed him on accident. Ducked his eyeball out. I'm not, but my friend used to be. He left. It got too much. He worked in the highest category prison where there were rapists, murderers, kiddie fiddlers, the worst of the worst. He told loads of stories, but the one that sticks with me was the time an inmate who was in prison for child abuse called for help to see a DR. The guards asked why and he wouldn't say, so they said no. He kept on calling and asking, and they kept on asking why and he wouldn't answer, so they kept saying no until he got real desperate. He didn't say anything, he was just curled up on his bed when he lifted the sheets up and there was blood everywhere. He'd been sexually assaulted with some sort of instrument and they tried to cut his D off. Brutal. He also said that sex between the male inmates is not viewed as gay, which I thought was interesting. Psych patient. After placed in an observation cell, pulls a razor out of his anus and proceeds to go to town on his genitals. Inmate in segregation would regularly eat his own it. Multiple bad fights and suicide attempts. Contractor fell 30 feet. Ankle was completely 90 degrees to his leg. Refused an ambulance or medical assistance for fear of being drug tested, assuming. Had two guys working with him help him walk the half mile to the front gate. Worst by far was a seg inmate slipping his cuffs. Removing an officer's bean slot bar. Big chunk of iron with a prong on the end we used to open slots in the cell doors to pass trays through handcuff inmates. And beat him to death with it. Was one of the first responders. I quit shortly after this one. Edit. Never worked there. But an inmate at the local county jail 2 weeks ago beat two female guards. Killing one and leaving the other with brain damage. One of them worked for my mom for years. The world sucks. I had a professor who was previously a corrections worker who had a mentally ill man lay his D out on the food tray door magic portal and she instinctively stepped back and kicked the tray door magic portal closed. If he'd been a little slower he would have been a few inches shorter. An inmate in segregation got very upset that he didn't get some paper a co-promise to get him on first shift. Ducker ripped off his own big toenail and cut up his arm with it. Not me, but my uncle. He has been a prison guard for 10 years. He has seen countless of things. But there was one thing that has always stuck with his mind. A little back information. My uncle is a chill guy. He is the kind of dude that would give inmates more minutes on the phone to call with their wife. Provide them with a little extra comfort when they had it dire. Think solitary confinement. And was overall a human among imprisoned humans. This, of course, made him gain respect from the inmates. As he treated them like humans. However, in his last year, he substituted for one of his colleagues one night and that was when it went crazy. Five inmates had very carefully planned out a breakout, which required a hostage. As they had some respect for my uncle, they didn't want to do it to him and therefore specifically chose a day that he wouldn't be there. But yeah, they wanted to break out anyway and if you set something in motion, you know. You can't stop a roller coaster when it has already started going down. So they took him hostage, and one of the inmates said while holding a gun to my uncle's head, "You aren't supposed to be here. Why the duck are you here?" My uncle was shocked. Quite logical if you ask me. And the other inmates made a run for it. However, two of them, the hostage taker, were shot in the knee, and that is when the inmates stopped the escape. Uncle made it out alive. Had two pain weeks of and went on a de-traumatizing holiday with wife. TLDR. Uncle was at wrong time, wrong place. Edit. Wasn't finished yet. Guy sculpted a parrot out of his own poo. He would place it on his shoulder and talk to it all the time. After 3 days the smell was unbearable. On the fourth day, he refused to come out of his cell for a shakedown. He kept threatening to kill his parrot if we came in his cell. The second we opened the door to extract him, he grabs the poo parrot off his shoulder and bites the head off and chews it. That is probably the craziest, nastiest thing I've seen. So my father was actually a prison guard a long time ago when I was a kid. And by a long time ago I mean like 17 years ago. But anyways, keep in mind my father is religious and doesn't necessarily like gays or trans. But he does support their rights as human beings. He always tells me this story about this man who wanted to become a female. So while the guy was in prison, he cut his D off and flushed it down the toilet. And since toilets in prison have garbage disposals at the bottom, there is no way to recover it at all. My dad is holding this guy's crotch area while this man is bleeding out. Of course, he's holding with a towel, but I can't imagine the amount of blood coming out of this area. Paramedics came and everything. Can't recall if the guy lives or not, and I don't wanna know, cause the thought of that guy makes my D hurt every time. Edit. I honestly don't know how my dad did it. My dad doesn't mind blood and actually watched in on my foot surgery while I was passed out, and watched some guy's eye surgery and loved both of them. But holding a bleeding guy's crotch is insane to me, even though it is my father.